Welcome back to Henry's Documentary. Today I'm going to be showing you what two of my days looked like. This video will be going up on Tuesday, so this is Saturday, July 23rd, and Monday, July 25th. Mainly workouts and cooking and working and studying real estate and stuff that I've learned, so let's get into it.
Good morning, happy Saturday. We're in the gym right now. I'm house sitting. I'm gonna do a workout. It's about 9 o'clock right now. I edited, I learned that yesterday. You don't wanna sit with the light behind you. I edited and posted my second video yesterday. I'm happy that I stuck with it. It wasn't exactly what I wanted it to be. I wanted it to be more of like the videos telling the story and then me talking in the background or like in between. It was just kind of too much. I didn't have the right videos, so I just kind of ditched that idea. I had a good little talk that I had that was about 4 minutes long, but it's cool. It's all a process. It's all about getting better. My best video is not gonna be my second video. Yeah, let's get into this workout, man.
For this workout, I'm doing 4x8 of everything and supersetting most of the stuff. So here you'll see the bench press and the dips is supersetted. And then the wide grip pulls and the leg kicks. Flexing the legs right here, man. You know what I'm saying? Get the quads up. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Don't got the core yet, but the calves are almost there too. I do a lot of calves to failure right now. I didn't even know my calves looked like that, to be honest, until I saw it on here. Then I got an ab workout right here. Igor, the man on YouTube. His video has got like 7 million views, bro. Doing this one in quarantine a lot, so it gives me that memory. You know what I'm saying? I like quarantine, man. I was working out, I was playing video games. That's where I grew the most, to be honest. I grew heavy. Here we got a journaling session. Got some good thoughts out, just what I'm thankful for. I also read the book of Matthew, sorry. I read 3 chapters of Matthew. I've never really read the gospel in-depthly. I didn't take any notes or anything, but it was very easy to read compared to like Proverbs where you're kind of learning to learn. That was like a more reading, you know what I mean? I just got home from the farmer's market. Also, I'm house sitting. This is in my crib.
Milk. Milk. Chicken. Eggs. $4, $6, $14. Okay, all right. Yeah, this was 5, 6, 14. So 24 plus 5 for the smoothie. It was about 30 bucks. So this, one a day for lunch. This, if I eat 5 eggs, all right, let's just say I eat 4. This is like 3 days of food, and it's not even everything that I would need.
So yeah, I spent about 30 bucks at the farmer's market for 3 days worth of food. But you know, eating local is a lot better for you than anything else.
But it's worth it. Eggs masterclass. Four.
Keep it uneven.
5 of them things, bro.
I love to make eggs. I make eggs every single day, and especially with cheese, man, it makes it so much better.
Some butter on here. I've been cooking it at a high heat recently. Smiley face spatula. Bring it all to the middle.
These were some of the best eggs I've made. It would have been way better with Colby Jack or Monterey Jack. I don't know.
Ooh, that looks good.
After I made breakfast at 1 p.m., I decided to go study real estate. I didn't work as much as I wanted to, but I put in work every single day to study for this license. And, well, I got to put in the 40 hours for the class, so I'm putting in work for that, but to then take the test, you know what I'm saying? Then I started studying GoPros. I don't actually know how I got home. I don't know what day this is from, but I studied GoPros and like the different settings for time lapse and everything. And that's what I'm doing here. Now it's time for what I've been waiting for. Show you, I wake up. This isn't when I wake up, but I get in the car, 5:30, drive to the gym. And the thing that's best is like I'm beating the sun up and I get to see this sunrise. Win-win. So when I get to the gym, I usually warm up with like 100 to 150 jumping jacks. That's also helping my calves out a lot. But today I'm doing a lot of squat building, and then I'm actually gonna do the same exact workout I did this Saturday that I've already shown after I do back squats, front squats, and pause squats. Here's the weights I was using for all those back squats. The sunrise here is beautiful, man. It's like you can see everything while it's coming up. And now I'm about to get into the same exact workout that I did on Saturday with the 4x8s and the supersets. Also, just like I like to warm up dynamically, I like to cool down statically. So it's either you doing static stretches or rolling out on the foam roller. After the gym, I went home and made some more eggs for breakfast. I usually make 5. I add about 1/3 of a cup of cheese, and then afterwards I put something called nutritional yeast on it, which I'm gonna put you on right now. Nutritional yeast, it's got a lot of vitamin B, which everyone is usually deficient in because everything that it comes in it's a water-soluble vitamin. So when you cook vitamin B, it cooks the vitamin out of it. And you can find vitamin B in like your meats and your vegetables, but if you're cooking them, you're not getting your vitamin B. So nutritional yeast gives you vitamin B, which gives you energy, which is what combats the fear center in your brain. Less anxiety, more focus. Nutritional yeast, man. That's all I'm gonna say. So I just gave you the keys. That's all I'm gonna say. After I got home with breakfast, I went in and studied real estate before I went to work. I think I got about an hour in. I'm taking a lot of notes, but it doesn't really seem like they're necessary. You know what I mean? I don't know, it's kind of weird. Like, I feel like I'm just writing a bunch of information now. That's exactly what I'm doing, but there's a lot of highlighted stuff in there, and it's hard to differentiate what's very meaningful and what's just highlighted just so they can have something to keep you engaged or whatever. After I got done studying a little bit of real estate, I went on to work where I cleaned out a pool. You can actually kind of see some of the dirt moving in there. That's kind of interesting. After I got done cleaning out the pool, I got assigned the task to go clean out a manure barn. So that's what you see me doing here. Very time consuming task, very annoying task, but got the job done. What a beautiful day. After I got done working, I went on to study some more real estate. I think I did this for about 2 or 3 hours. Overall, a good day, a good amount of studying completed. What's crazy is I try to think about while I'm doing it, like, if someone asked me what I learned today, what would I say? And I often have nothing. It's kind of hard to process. It might just be because I'm taking in so much information. That's hard to really differentiate between what's important and what's not. Alright, after I got done with real estate, I went to my girlfriend's house to have dinner. I didn't really record anything of that. I hung out with her for a little bit. And then I came home, wrote out my 3 tasks for Tuesday. Right now I'm reading Tim Ferriss's 4-Hour Workweek and studying James chapter 1 in the Bible. Today is the end of Monday, July 25th. I had a really good day and I time-lapsed pretty much everything that happened today. And I plan to edit the video tomorrow, hopefully create something very cool. To round out the night, which was the last couple things I did, I made something that I've been doing that's been very important, has been writing out the top 3 tasks that I need to accomplish the next day. What I've discovered is it's easier when you're going to bed, heading towards the end of the night. You can analyze your day, take out the pieces that were missing, right? So like, these are the things that didn't get accomplished. But like, let's say you don't write those down. You wake up the next day and you remember them in the middle of the day. Then you add those things into the things you already need to do and establish at the beginning of the day. You just get so wrapped up now that like you remembered you had these things, but they kind of came out of nowhere at the same time. So writing them down the night before you go to bed, where you have a little bit more clarity, you can identify what's important, can help you out a lot when it comes to the next day when it's time to do these tasks. That's something that I'm trying to be consistent about, and I have been pretty consistent about. I also read a chapter of 4-Hour Workweek. Now, this book, I'm kind of just skimming through. I know it has valuable content, but not all of it really applies to me right now. From what I read one chapter. It just emphasized a point that has been repeated throughout the book, which is a lot of times it's better to ask for forgiveness rather than permission. Also, it has to do with negotiation, and that's to never appear as though you are the final decision maker. And that can give you a little bit more power when it comes to having to negotiate things, whether it's, you know, for me, it might be real estate deals, might be something with the podcast, just talking to people in general, doing business, doing things where you might need to leverage, you know, a decision where that you have to make. You are the final decision maker, but don't appear that way to the person you're conducting this conversation with. Negotiation is something that's pretty interesting to me. I feel like I've always had a sort of natural way to not necessarily get what I want out of somebody, plead my case and not give in a non-victimizing way. That's something my mom has always said. At least I remember being younger, like elementary, middle school. And my mom would say something along the line of, I think you'll go
into something where you need to negotiate, because that is something that you like to do. I will say though, takeaway from studying real estate is I like that I'm learning the legal side of things, especially being so young, so novice to the real estate game when it comes to the consumer side, being that I've never bought a home, never really haven't known anybody who's bought a home yet amongst my peers. I think it's really interesting and really beneficial. Great decision, honestly. Very good decision to start getting my real estate license. And then I did a very good Bible study on about 4 verses in the book of James, which led me to book chapters, verses of the Bible in Luke that correlate with the book of James, which I'm going to break down on the podcast this week. I'm really happy. I'm really excited, man. Life's been going great. At least I've been able to see life in a very good light, and I'm very happy about it.
All right, thank you for watching today's episode of Henry's Documentary. I'll be back on Friday for another video. Subscribe to the journey. See you in a bit.